I guess the main thing you want is their withers to be up under you. I say that backed up with that head down, you know, because I like it on this mare. But if a horse doesn't put that head down because they are built, you know, not low-headed, you don't want to make that a big deal, because if that head naturally sits a little higher and they're comfortable, you want them to stay comfortable. I think most of us like a low-headed horse that's comfortable low-headed, but it's not a priority. She's just a little more horse, and so I've had to do more with her to get control of what she's wanting to do. I don't want to give her nowhere to go with that energy, and so with all that extra energy, I may have to back her a little bit more. I may have to pick her up and direct it a little bit more. It seems like every time you say this is what I like, or this works for me, or this is kind of a good rule of thumb, there's one that makes you sort of change your ideas a little bit. So each horse is an individual, and steers, I think, are it kind of puts them up against competition that's adequate for their skill level, you know. Just like I was saying, if you've got a good fifth grade athlete, you know, you're not gonna put him up against Michael Jordan and say you better handle this good. There's no way for them to handle that yet. So put them up against something that they can handle,